G Fuel's new flavor, Rainbow Sherbet, is now available. Link is at the top of the description. Use promo code CHAOS and tweet me if you do. With all of the great video game franchises that have come and gone, it's interesting to look back and think about the ones that have actually died out, the ones that have just started recently, and the ones that are on their way out the door. But you guys probably know there are some video game franchises that will never die. They are immortal. They are invincible. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10. And today we are going to be counting down the picks for the top 10 video game series that will never die. These are those franchises that have been around forever and are definitely nowhere being done with you or me. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Take advantage of the giveaway, be subscribed with your notifications on, and let's jump right into this top 10. Kicking off our list today is the franchise in Assassin's Creed. The world was introduced to Assassin's Creed back in 2007. The first game got positive reception for its story and concept, but it was criticized for its actual gameplay, which really honestly wasn't the best. But with Assassin's Creed 2, the franchise became what we know today. Great action and awesome story spanning tons of different time eras, plenty of secrets to explore, and an open world in the newer games. Assassin's Creed is an awesome series. While they did have a hiccup with recent games due to Ubisoft rushing them out, they've gone back to taking their time with the new game coming out later this year. Due to a great fan base, ever-changing gameplay, and the fact that it can take place in literally any time era, I don't think that Assassin's Creed is going to die out anytime soon. They could go biblical times, prehistoric, far future. They could do anything with this series. One you may not expect to be on the list, but it's pretty much impervious to being killed off. At number 9, we have LEGO. Not only are LEGO video games awesome, LEGO movies are awesome too. LEGO video games have been around since the 90s. There was LEGO Island, LEGO Racers, but the real LEGO game started in 2005 with the first LEGO Star Wars game, which is not only a fantastic game, but also laid the foundation for the rest of the games to come. It's easy to just write these off due to how many there are, but these games are actually tons of fun. In fact, LEGO Marvel Super Heroes from 2013 is widely regarded as one of the best superhero games ever made. Due to their simplicity, super wide influence, and their audience, it's just plain fun. It really is. If you've never played one, you should. It's pretty unlikely that the LEGO games will ever die out, and I don't think that's a bad thing. I mean, kids love LEGOs. I love LEGOs. At number 8 is quite possibly one of the most iconic game franchises of all time in the form of Tomb Raider. It's been around since 1996 and it's not going anywhere. It's covered tons of different game styles as well, further solidifying its staying power. It has been a third-person platformer, a top-down shooter, and an open world adventure game. It's also been a family-friendly game. It's been a darker, more graphic and mature game. It can bounce back and forth whenever it wants to. Honestly, Tomb Raider isn't going anywhere as long as they keep Lara fresh and exciting and continue to change with the times. Now, there was a time when people thought this number 7 entry may have been dying, but it's not so. Sonic the Hedgehog, and many people say Sonic is dead or whatever, but the fact of the matter is, he's not. Sure, since Sonic in 2006 was a disaster, the series continued on after that, and Sonic Boom in 2014 was also a train wreck, but Sonic is still around. It is a shame that Sonic isn't exactly known for having good games nowadays, and you can pretty much count on Sega to give us a crappy Sonic game every year or two, but the fact of the matter is, the games are still coming, and they are still selling. I mean, he's Sega's mascot. I don't see him going anywhere anytime soon. The Sonic games from the Sega Genesis are some of the greatest games ever made, and they need to bring that back. They need to just go back to their roots with their next one. At number six, one of my favorite franchises of all time. Guess in the comments before I tell you. You already see it on the screen. Halo! It has seen its fair share of variation, from its humble beginnings as a simple, straightforward FPS to its evolution with every new game. Halo has come a long, long way since its inception, and some fans even say it went too far. But it's right there and it keeps on going. The developers have plenty of room to work with in the Halo universe, given how huge and expansive and the lore is, and they have a passionate fan base. That is a recipe for a continued series. While the game nowadays isn't much like it used to be, the franchise itself is, it's going to keep on going for a long, long time. Okay, let's crack into the top five, and I know what some of you are going to say here. Call of Duty, and you're going to be like, boo-hoo, Infinite Warfare, boo-hoo, COD is dead. Well, tell that to the millions and millions of copies sold every single year like clockwork. As much as people like to take a dump on Call of Duty, the franchise is doing great and it's not going anywhere. The series has been everywhere. World War II, modern day, near future, far future. Call of Duty has been all over the place in terms of setting and gameplay style, and that's what's keeping it going and what's going to keep it going for the foreseeable future. COD isn't dead, and it's probably never going to be dead thanks to its loyal fan base, changing style, and honestly, arcade-addicting gameplay. At number four, we have Grand Theft Auto, and there's just something so addicting about the GTA game. Sure, there are tons of other open-world games that let you do whatever you want to in a city, be the biggest criminal in history, but none of them do it quite like GTA, not to mention all the new features we saw in GTA 5 that are bound to come back in GTA Online, a story with three protagonists and those wonderful and addicting heists. The series has been around since 1997, and honestly, there has yet to be an entry that wasn't insanely addicting and financially successful, which is the real reason it's not going anywhere. So if you're a fan of Grand Theft Auto, do not worry. It will probably never die. Talk about a mega franchise at number three, Final Fantasy. And have you ever thought to yourself, how many Final Fantasy games are there? Well, have fun figuring that out after 20 years. Let me know in the comment section how many total games you think there are across the entire universe, okay? It's not going anywhere. It came out in 1987 for the NES and has since been countless main installments and spinoffs. Right now, there are 15 main installments, 16 if you count Final Fantasy X2, and there have been a ton of other spin-offs, expansions, and remakes of the older games. Why, you may ask? Well, because it's good. Final Fantasy has an insanely deep lore, beautiful worlds and gameplay, and a passionate fan base that just, they jones for the next installment, whatever it may be. Plus, with the Final Fantasy VII Remake and Final Fantasy 16 in development, we're going to be getting new games in the series any year now. At number two, we have Pokemon. Originating all the way back in 1996 with Pokemon Red and Green, Pokemon has since grown into one of the biggest media properties to ever exist. From the games, to the card game, to the manga, to the anime, Pokemon has been around forever and it's not going anywhere. With such a huge world and massive roster of creatures already in existence, it's been relatively easy for the developers to add new characters and Pokemon to the new installments as well as remake the classic games for a new generation of fans. The Pokemon universe is up to Generation 7, and they're not stopping there. They could go to 50, probably. There's so many fans. They would just be doing them an injustice if they just stopped doing Pokemon. Could you imagine a world without Pokemon? If you don't like Pokemon, you'd probably like that, but trust me, it's not going anywhere. Okay, we've reached the number one spot, and there's really never a doubt with this one. I'm sure you guys can guess in the comment section where we are going with this, but you cannot not put Mario at number one. First appearing in the Donkey Kong arcade game all the way back in 1981. Mario has since become the mascot of the gaming industry. So far, Mario, are you ready for this, has appeared in 116 different games, not including remakes or re-releases or hidden Easter eggs, and he's not going to stop there. Mario is a gaming icon. Just looking at the guy makes you think of all the memories you've had with this franchise at whatever age. It connects all ages together. He's been everywhere, from 2D platforming to RPGs to 3D platforming to racing to 360 platforming, or whatever you want to call Super Mario Galaxy. And Mario isn't going anywhere. I don't think anyone is upset about that. I just want to say thank you, Mario, for everything you have done for the world. Even though you're a made-up digital character, you've changed a lot of lives. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 video game series that will probably never die. Let us know what ones we missed. There's a playlist below if you guys want to check out all the other gaming top 10s and put up a brand new one every single night at 8 o'clock Central Standard Time. Thank you for all the love on the channel, guys. Hope you have a fantastic night.